Hi, and welcome to part three of my RC airboat build. Today I'm gonna talk about the whole installation of the electronics, the battery compartment, and the servo modification, and the last mods I had to do for linking the rudder. So first let's have a look at the servo. What I still had to do is the modification to make it waterproof and to connect the servo with the rudder. For the modifications to make it waterproof, I firstly cut out the mounting arms on both sides just to make the servo a little bit smaller and looking cleaner. Then I removed the upper part of the housing just to make it possible to put some grease onto the top bearing. It's a Molycoat grease which avoids water to come in to the gears of the servo in case of flipping the boat upside down or any kind of water which comes right to the servo. The second mod is that I used some Uhu Pour to close all the seams around the servo, and at the same time I also glued the servo with some Uhu Pour onto the motor mount. To connect the servo to the rudder, I simply used some RC plane hardware, just a simple steel link which connects the servo and the rudder horn. To make the battery fit better, I had to do a separate wall which makes the battery fit exactly into this compartment, so I have a nice battery compartment. Later I will do also something which secures the battery in the place, also in case of flipping the boat upside down. At the moment it can fall out of the boat, but for a first function test that was enough. I just used some tape to fix the battery. Then let's have a look at the electronics. All electronics are now installed into the plastic box. I used all clear shrink tape to shrink all the electronics. At the ESC, I used some cooling elements from another ESC, which I cut it into the right size and put it onto the ESC. And to transfer the heat better into the cooling aluminum, I used some compound which regularly is used for CPUs for computers. This also works perfectly for FETs on an ESC to transfer the heat into the cooling element. And I also fixed this with some clear shrink tube. Then I used some double-sided tape to fix all the components in the bottom of the box and wired up the whole stuff. To wire up the servo, I had to cut off the connector of the servo and just straight soldered the servo cables onto the RC receiver. And so we have a pretty clean wiring now. We have power from the battery, which goes to the ESC. From the ESC we have power which goes through the Pololu step down, which transfers battery voltage down to 5 volts, and with these 5 volts I can power the Futaba fast receiver. And then we have, as already mentioned, servo with power and signal, and we have the white cable which is the signal for the ESC. And then we have the 3 cables for the motor, which go straight back to the Lumineer drone motor. The holes I drilled into the box are not yet waterproof. I have to seal these. That's the reason also why I did the first test run on grass and not on water, just because the whole electronics is not already waterproof. The electronics test on the grass was okay for the electronics. The ESC kept pretty cool. I just realized that I have way too much power with this setup of motor and prop. And we will see if I will keep this motor and prop or I will change the components. I'm not sure yet. I have to test it on water too. But there is plenty of power for this size and weight of boat. The boat weighs only, without battery, 124 grams, and including the battery, 212 grams, so it's pretty lightweight. The downside of the test I did on grass is that it's absolutely impossible to drive this boat straight. It always turned around, you have absolutely no control, and I think the reason, or the main reason, is that the lower side of the hull is completely flat. So what I'm gonna do for next mod is that I integrate some fins on both sides of the hull, the whole length of the hull, to get it more stable. I'm not sure if this is needed also in water, but I will do this modification because I also like to run it on snow in winter, and also perhaps in summer on grass, and hopefully the fins will help to keep the boat straight. Other next steps will be to do the final foam parts, the top plate in front, top plate over the electronics, and also sealing the electronics. So I will also use my Uhu pore glue just to close all the holes I drilled for battery cables, motor cables, servo and antenna, just to make sure the electronics box will be as waterproof as possible. This is all about today's update. Thanks for watching. Have a good time. Happy flying, happy driving. Bye bye.